All right, Dame. Well, changing gears just a little bit. I'm trying to draw your attention to something that has caught my eye, and I wonder if you guys have noticed it too. And it all has to do with this argument. We've talked about it a lot here, and we've seen it all over the place, I should say. The culture war argument that has been raging. I mean, we see it every day as the deep state media continues to stoke the fires of division and hate. And you can't go past any type of news channel or social media without seeing posts about how awful we are as a nation and how systemic racism is this, sexism that. I mean, if there's a box you should be put into, you'll be lumped into it, along with the scandemic and locking down of our way of life overall. It's a recipe for depression, and it just gives you the ugly feeling of blah. So whenever I see things like, say, this, you know, or maybe someone like this, and she's one of my favorites too, I'm struck really by how angry and unhappy all these people are. I mean, about everything about these people and what they do and what they stand for. And it all seems to have one thing in common. It's negative. All of it.
Yeah.
I mean, what even is that? How do you live your life this way?
Yeah.
That's when I realized that the culture war isn't really about our culture as much as it is about our mindset, which I guess is part of our culture. But for this, I'm going to keep it separate. It's kind of an attack, not only on our way of life, but the way we think about our lives. Okay. I mean, who loves to hear someone complain and go, "Oh, woe is me," all that nonsense. Anyone? No? Yeah, I didn't think so. What do they say when soldiers are all fighting in foreign lands? It's now about winning the hearts and minds, right? Well, this is exactly what this election and with President Trump is really all about. As much as they try to make it about culture and divide us along these lines, they are failing. And conversely, we are winning. I mean, this culture war has been lost because the left realizes one thing, that hate and division can't beat a positive attitude. Yeah. Loving your country is actually good.
Yeah.
Okay. Whether it's the Bible or the founding of our nation, history is full of examples of how a positive mental attitude can be the difference between winning and losing, as we saw in the 2016 election. And we all know President Trump loves winning.
We will have so much winning if I get elected that you may get bored with winning.
Right.
Believe me. I agree. You'll never get bored with winning. We never get bored.
Yeah. You know, there's a quote from Henry Ford that he made famous that goes, "Whether you believe you can or you can't, you're right." Well, what does that mean? Well, it speaks to the mindset, again, of what I'm talking about, that if you think you can't do something, you've already lost. And that's the exact mindset the left and the Democrats want you to have. The left doesn't want you to believe that life can be better, especially if it can be better without them. It's like a long-time Democratic voters have had their party hijacked and are now being held hostage right now and are suffering from a political form of the Helsinki syndrome.
As in Helsinki, Sweden. Finland.
Yeah. If Democrats are so happy, then, you know, I don't know. How come they don't tell their face? You know why? Because they're losing and they know it, which is why they're lashing out like never before. We see it all over. You've got Antifa, BLM, the violence is raging because they are losing. And again, they know it. Just don't let that get you down. Keep clear of the liberal piss mist that's out there and keep your head up. I mean, don't believe the propaganda the news pumps out every single day that, because all that is fear porn. I mean, open your eyes and see your things around you and what they really are, not how awful they keep telling you it is. Guess what? The sky isn't falling. The world isn't ending. And like I said, liberals are losing, and it's in their DNA. It's their culture.
Yeah.
It's their mindset, and they're trying to turn you and our country into them.
Now, let me say this before I move forward, and I can't explain it, but you better feel me. Winners win and losers lose.
Yeah.
I can't explain it any better than that. I don't know how it happens, but winners win. And if you create a culture of losing, if you keep being a victim, if you keep letting losing happen to you, if you keep letting people do you and treat you any kind of way, it's gonna become a culture.
Yeah. And that's what it's all about. Great words to live by, but from Eric Thomas, and words to live by yourself as well.
All right, Rick Delgado. What even is that? I like that one.